Now we have completed the definition of electric field, how to find the electric field at a point due to a point charge, and also superposition principle. Using these ideas, let us find the electric field at a point due to a configuration of charges. Q1 is situated on the x-axis at a distance of 2 mm from the origin. Q2 is a 1 microcoulomb that is also situated at a distance of 2 mm from the origin. To find the electric field at the point A, we have to use superposition principle. Using superposition principle, we can write like this. Electric field at a point A is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. First charge is Q1. Distance from the first charge to the point is R1A, its square. Then R1A cap is a unit vector from the first charge to the point. So it is acting along positive y-axis. Similarly, electric field at the point due to the second charge, Q2, its R2A cap is the unit vector from the second charge to the point. It is acting along the positive x-axis. So we can substitute for 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, 9 into 10 raised to 9. Then for the charge, 1 into 10 raised to minus 6, because it is a microcoulomb. Then R1A cap is a unit vector from the first charge to the point, that is along the y-axis. So unit vector along the y-axis is J cap. Similarly here, this field here, because of the second charge, is acting along the x-axis. Unit vector along the x-axis is I cap. Second charge is also 1 microcoulomb. Distance is 2 millimeter. Now, this calculation can be done very easily. Minus 3 into 2, minus 6, that will get cancelled. This 10 raised to minus 6, 10 raised to minus 6 will get cancelled. Then 9 divided by 2 square. 2 square is 4, 9 divided by 4 is 2.25. So you are getting the value for this. Similarly, here also you simplify. Now 2.25 into this 10 raised to 9, you can take it outside. Then I plus J. So this is the electric field. Electric field is a vector quantity. So you find the magnitude of that. So magnitude of this can be got by this relation. Square root of the square plus square of this. Already you are familiar how to get the resultant of two vectors. This is one vector, this is another vector. So its resultant is given by this. Now, if a vector is divided by its magnitude, you will get the unit vector. A vector is divided by its magnitude. So we are getting a unit vector. The direction of the unit vector is along OA. So here, electric field due to the first charge is acting along this direction. That is E1A. Electric field due to the second charge is E2A. So its resultant will be acting along this direction. I vector is acting along this direction. J vector is acting along this direction. So I plus J is acting along this direction. So you know the triangle law of vector addition. This is I vector. This is J vector. So I plus J is a vector acting along this direction. So I plus J is divided by root 2. So it's a unit vector. This is acting along OA. So this is the direction of the resultant intensity. Then magnitude is given by this. Magnitude of the electric field is 2.25 into 10 raised to 9 root 2. And direction is given by this vector.